today I'm going to tell you about a beautiful town, famous for art, music, sports cars, and even a journey into hell. Lucca is a Tuscan city near the Ligurian Sea, and it is known as a Renaissance town with a proud musical and operatic heritage. Early Lucca was probably settled by the Ligurians and the Etruscans. The Romans developed a real Roman town here in 180 BC. Lucca still retains the original rectangular Roman grid street plan. The Piazza del Anfiteatro still has traces of the Roman amphitheatre. Julius Caesar, Pompey, and Crassus held a conference in 56 BC here in Lucca to cement their political alliance, which was called the First Triumvirate.
To learn more about La Bella Italia, consider subscribing.
Lucca was sacked by Odoacer, the first Germanic king of Italy. It was an important city with a fortress, as Narses, the Byzantine general, besieged it in 553. Between 576 and 797, it was a Lombard capital. The apparently famous relic, Holy Face of Lucca, known as Volto Santo, apparently carved by Nicodemus, arrived in Lucca in 742. As a result, Lucca was part of the Via Francigena pilgrimage route to Rome. Lucca became a largely independent settlement. Its textile industry was very important in the medieval period. Its silk trade would compete with Byzantium. In 1057, Anselm of Baggio, who was later promoted to Pope and called Alexander II, rebuilt the cathedral, the Duomo. Between 1073 and 1086, his nephew Anselm II featured in the investiture controversy. This was part of the ongoing battle between Pope Gregory VII and Henry IV. Dante's Divine Comedy actually referenced citizens of Lucca, and he also spent some of his exile years here in Lucca. Ubaldo Alucingoli even became Pope Lucius III in 1181. From 1273, Lucca was ruled by Lucchetto Gattiluzio of Genoa, and he was instrumental in creating an alliance against nearby Pisa. Lucca was now a leading state in central Italy, rivaling Florence. In 1314, Uguccione della Fagiola of Pisa arrived and sacked Lucca. He was driven out by the citizens of Lucca in 1316. In 1325, the Ghibellines of Lucca, led by Castruccio Castragani, defeated the Guelphs of Florence in the Battle of Altobascio. Having brought destruction right up to the outskirts of Florence, Castruccio Castragani was appointed Duke of Lucca. In 1408, Lucca hosted an ultimately unsuccessful gathering arranged by Pope Gregory XII to discuss a disagreement over who should be Pope. French and Austrian forces fought it over Lucca between 1799 and 1800. The French won and briefly granted Lucca a democratic constitution. In 1805, the Republic of Lucca was ruled by Elisa Bonaparte Bacciocchi, the Princess of Lucca and sister of Napoleon Bonaparte. As a result of the Treaty of Vienna in 1815, the Duchy of Lucca was temporarily annexed to the Bourbon-Parma Duchy. In 1847, the Duchy of Lucca passed to the Grand Duchy of Tuscany, which became part of the Kingdom of Sardinia-Piedmont in 1860. There was a prisoner of war camp at the village of Colle di Compito between 1942 and 1944. Things to see in Lucca. Where you could view the Renaissance-era city walls and walk the city centre. Piazza del Anfiteatro stands on the site of the original Roman amphitheatre. See the Ducal Palace, which was the residence of Elisa Bonaparte. Enjoy the spectacular view from the Giunigi Tower, the famous tree-lined tower which dates back to the 1300s. St. Martin's Cathedral, built in a range of styles. If opera's your thing, visit the house and museum of Puccini, where the composer lived until 1880. The Pfanner Palace and Garden is now an arts museum. The Torre delle Ore, the clock tower, is the tallest defence tower in Lucca. Both Machiavelli and Mary Shelley wrote about Castruccio Castragani. Lucca hosts the annual Summer Festival of Pop Music, a film festival, a digital photography festival, a jazz festival, and of course, a Puccini festival. 13th of September, there is a nighttime candlelit procession of Santa Croce with people dressed in medieval costume. The TV show Top Gear filmed here. There are lots of local products to sample in Lucca. Try the salty Lucca bread, rovelline alla lucchese, which are fried meat slices with tomato and capers. Gadmuggia, soup made of artichokes, asparagus, broad beans and peas. Biroldo, a cured meat made from pork blood and offal. If you like cake, try castagnaccio. If you like liqueurs, we'll try biandina and cina massagli. If you prefer wine, try the reds here, Colline Lucchesi and Monte Carlo. Lucca's most famous son is obviously the opera composer Giacomo Puccini, who is famous for La Bohème, Madame Butterfly and Turandot. Others include Francesco Gemignani, a famous violinist and composer, Alfredo Catalani, an operatic composer, Luigi Boccherini, a composer and cellist, Nicolao Dorati, a Renaissance composer and trombone player. Giuseppe Guami was a composer and one of the finest organists in Italy in the 16th century. Benedetto Brandimatte, an artist in the Mannerist style. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, perhaps you might consider giving it a like so other people can see it. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.